This video is released under a Creative Commons license with attribution and share-alike conditions. This applies to the entirety of the video and its contents, except for the picture of SCP-173, which is held under private copyright and is briefly included in this video under fair use provisions. Otherwise, you may freely distribute, copy, modify, and share this video as long as it is attributed back to this video and SCP assets are attributed appropriately back to SCP. See the description for a list of attributions. The SCP Foundation is one of my favorite experiments in internet culture. I use the term experiment here not in a negative way, but that really is how I view it. Although I haven't been a diehard fan the whole time, I've been a reader since around 2012, coming back to it at different points in my life to revisit the universe. For those not familiar, the SCP Foundation is a shared fictional universe. It revolves around a world where anomalous phenomena, things that should not exist according to our laws, do exist. The Foundation, a shadowy organization with great power and questionable ethics, exists to contain these anomalous items and entities. The bulk of the storytelling is done through articles written in scientific format, each one a document explaining the anomaly. There are currently over 5,000 of these articles on the SCP official wiki, each written by a contributor from the internet. There is a process to get one published, currently involving getting your idea greenlit by two established writers, and then a voting system where only positively rated articles remain on the site. But beyond that, anybody can sign up and write a piece that becomes a part of SCP history. In my mind, this is one of the greatest things about it. No single person could write 5,000 unique entries with the amount of soul and individuality as the collective creative consciousness of the internet. Ideas have been experimented with and flipped on their heads in ways so unique that the contribution of so many unique perspectives has been essential in shaping the broad world that the SCP Foundation is today. Additionally, the growth of the community has altered the course of the stories created in a visible and tangible way. SCP articles are only up and up in series, blocks of 1,000 articles at a time. Each series must be filled up before a new one is completed, leading to significant time gaps between each, although these have gotten naturally shorter as the site becomes more popular. Reading through the website today, the shift of the community over time is notable. Each series has its own feel to the writing. One can see the trends that were popular in the community at the time, the transformation as noteworthy pieces inspired people in a new direction, and the expanding of the boundaries as people grew to seek new and novel stories. All of this, everything about it, is what makes the SCP Wiki awesome. And it's also the reason we will never see a commercial product released around the universe. Or rather, the protections that enable this to be a community effort are the reason why. This is because all SCP works exist under a licensing plan known as Creative Commons. Specifically, they are licensed under Creative Commons with attribution and share-alike requirements. What that means is that everything on the website, absolutely everything, is free for any person to take and use for any use, including commercial, as long as the SCP Wiki is attributed and any works are also released under the same license. The only exception I'm aware of at this time is the picture used for the original SCP article, SCP-173, which is held under license by the creator of the sculpture, who has kindly allowed the wiki to continue using it for the original document only. I am showing a brief image of it here under fair use protection. The terms of the license are quite clear, and the wiki itself makes it plainly known that it's not possible for any part of the SCP universe to exist under any licensing other than Creative Commons. There is even a section of the licensing guide related specifically to video game creators, from which I will excerpt the following. You are free to create and share video games based on SCP, but you must comply with all aspects of the license as it relates to software. That means releasing the work under Creative Commons by Sharealike 3.0, including the release statement prominently on any store page the game is distributed on, as well as developer websites and the like. Releasing the game without DRM if the game costs money, Steam and the like have developer options for this, not imposing additional legal restrictions through end-user license agreements or equivalent user forms, and not attempting to impede any alternate distribution sources so long as those sources in turn follow the terms of the license. In other words, no matter what you do, you can never hold exclusive license to any works involving the SCP Foundation. You can create freely and make money from your creations, but you can't stop anybody else from redistributing and even profiting from your work. And this is the crux of the issue as it relates to commercial releases. I want to be clear here that I'm referring to commercial releases as capital ventures meant to turn a profit, usually backed by investors or major studios. You can think of this as meaning AAA titles, for instance. No major studio is going to pour millions of dollars into something for which they can never hold the rights and can be freely copied and distributed. That doesn't mean that we won't see some major efforts to adapt the works of the SCP Foundation, only that they will inherently be projects of love. In fact, there are already fantastic SCP adaptations available, games such as SCP Containment Breach, Secret Lab, and SCP-3008, fan films such as SCP-096 and SCP Overlord. These creators do profit from their work, and in several cases you can buy their games right from Steam or other services, but these are not major commercially backed releases. Many of them are made possible by crowdfunding or community support, meaning they are still an extension of the community. Is this a bad thing ultimately? For some, I think it might be a bit disappointing. I think there are many SCP fans who would love to see a major SCP movie or AAA video game adaptation. I know it sounds exciting to me. But, in the end, I think it's the right choice and ultimately good for the protection of the franchise. What makes the SCP Foundation so special is that it's run and monitored by a community who are deeply invested in the fictional universe and spend a great deal of time developing it without any compensation to see it continue. To create a licensing plan which prevents any one person or group from owning the rights ensures that the lore will always be held and developed by the community who have a personal interest in it, which I believe is absolutely essential to the life that it has built so far. I don't think that people need to be upset for loss of opportunity, though. Just because the SCP Foundation and its assets are not likely to ever be developed by a major corporation, its existence has had a large impact on the internet fiction community and may have inspired other great projects. For me, it's hard to think of a better example than the video game Control, the developers of which have freely admitted to being inspired by SCP. In the end, there's nothing wrong with that. SCP still belongs to the community who put so much heart into it, and the success of the community continues to inspire people to think about our relationships with horror, fantasy, and storytelling, and how we can use them to both escape from and contextualize the challenges in our daily lives. If you've made it this far, thanks for giving me your time for a discussion on a topic I enjoy greatly. My channel is not dedicated to SCP, but I do find time to cover it and related topics on a semi-regular basis, so please feel free to subscribe if you'd like to stay notified for more content of that type. Feedback is always welcome in comments, and any interaction such as likes, comments, and subscriptions helps my content show up more on YouTube. It's a great way to help the channel if you enjoy the content, and always greatly appreciated. Until next time, it's been a pleasure as always. Thank you.